Bonjour! In this video, I will show you how to make this carved text effect in Procreate. With this tutorial, you will learn to use the perspective drawing guide to carve your text inside the pumpkin and how to use the liquify tool to distort your letter into the round shape of a pumpkin. And as always, the color palette is available for free thanks to the link just below this video. Okay, let's go! So first, choose the size of your canvas. In my case, I will use a screen size canvas. We're going to set a temporary background color. Choose this orange color from the color palette and drop it on your canvas. Now let's add the letter. First, choose this light yellow color from the color palette. Go to the Actions menu. Add. Then add text, then write your letter. Tap on the letter A in the middle right of your screen to access the Edit Style panel. I'll use the font Luckiest Guy, and you can download it thanks to the link below this video. And if you need to learn how to add a font in Procreate, I invite you to watch this video. Put your letter in a fairly large size, then tap Done. Tap the Transform tool and put your letter in the size you want. Go to your Layers panel, tap your layer and rasterize your text. Then bring back the Transform tool. Make sure that snapping is on and put your letter in the middle of your canvas. Now let's add the drawing guide. Tap the Actions menu, Canvas, toggle on Drawing Guide, then tap Edit Drawing Guide. Select the perspective guide at the bottom. Tap in the middle of your canvas to create a vanishing point and tap Done. If you want to learn more about using drawing guides, I invite you to watch this video. Select any dark color and grab a brush like the HB pencil. We are going to create the blueprint of your carved letter with this brush. Create a new layer. Tap on your layer, then tap Drawing Assist. Now all your lines go towards the vanishing point in the middle of your canvas. Create small lines that start from each edge of your letter. Disable Drawing Assist and create a parallel line of one side of your letter and intersect it with two lines you created earlier. Then repeat this process around your entire letter. Tap with two fingers on your layer and slide to the left to lower the opacity. Let's erase the parts we won't see in your letter. These are the two parts in the middle of your letter. Tap on your layer, then tap mask. Make sure your color button is black, then tap the selection tool. Choose the freehand mode, color fill, then follow your blueprint. On the top part, follow the line from your perspective drawing guide. Then follow the same process on the bottom part. Let's create the edges of your curved letter. Create a new layer below the layer with your letter. And choose this color. Tap the selection tool. Freehand mode and enable color fill. Then follow your blueprint all around your letter. For this part, create a new layer above your letter layer. Tap the selection tool, freehand mode and color fill, then create your selection. You can delete the layer with the blueprint and hide the drawing guide. Now create a new layer above this one. Tap on it, then enable clipping mask. If you want to learn more about clipping mask, I invite you to watch this video. Select this yellow color from the color palette. Tap the selection tool, freehand mode with color fill. Then select these two edges to separate them from the top and bottom edges. Let's add the halo emanating from the letter. Tap the layer with your letter. Then go to the adjustments menu and choose the bloom effect in layer mode. Drag to the right to adjust the amount of bloom. And use the sliders below to adjust the effect. Tap the adjustments icon when you are satisfied with the result. The edges of the halo are too sharp, so we'll soften them a bit. Tap your mask layer, go to the adjustments icon and choose the Gaussian blur in pencil filter mode. Use your Apple Pencil to apply the effect and slide on your canvas with your finger to adjust the strength of the blur. The idea is to apply the blur less and less as you get closer to the edge of your letter. Let's now set the color background. Choose this dark brown color and drop it on your background color layer. Then go to your brush library. airbrushing brush set and choose the soft brush. Select this brown color and use your brush in the middle of your canvas. Then use this lighter brown color in the middle. Make sure to keep the edges of the canvas dark to enhance the light dark contrast of your artwork. Let's add a texture to your artwork. Create a new layer on top. Tap the letter N next to your layer. Then choose the blend mode overlay. Select a white color. Go to your brush library, industrial brush set, and choose the Wasteland brush. Apply your brush over all your canvas. Then tap on your layer with two fingers to adjust the opacity. Let's now create the rounded shape of your letter. You can merge all your letters by pitching them on your layers panel. Go to the adjustments menu and choose liquify. Choose the expand mode at the bottom with the maximum size and pressure but no distortion or momentum. Then apply the liquify tool in the middle of your canvas and lift off your Apple Pencil before your letter gets too big. Tap adjust below, then use the slider to adjust the strength of the effect. When you are satisfied, tap the adjustments icon to commit. For the finishing touches, go to the adjustments menu. Tap Sharpen Layer, slide to adjust to around 50%. Go to the Adjustments menu again. Tap Chromatic Aberration in Layer Mode. Slide to adjust to around 5%. Go back to the Adjustments menu one last time. Tap Noise Layer and slide to adjust to 5%. Et voilà. If you find this tutorial helpful, the best thing you can do to support me is to click on the like button and to subscribe to my channel for more lettering tutorials in Procreate. I'd like also to take this opportunity to tell you that I have created a free course to help you get started in Procreate. If you are interested, the link is in the description. So until the next one, bonsoir.